We lost 85,000 jobs last month, but the unemployment rate remains the same. There is a money manager who's trying to grow farms in the city of Detroit. I'm going to be on the radio, and I'm going to talk about the possibility of the housing market going through a double dip. Hello, it's January 8th, 2010. I almost said 9. First, we lost 85,000 jobs last month. In December, people were expecting some type of growth, and I thought we would have some type of growth because during December, you at least have a lot of temporary workers, a lot of seasonal workers in retail, so I thought we would have some type of boost that way, and we have been losing less, and we've been losing more jobs, but we haven't been losing jobs at the same rate as we did earlier this year, and a lot of people have been trying to sell that as good news. So, I mean, they were talking about a possible gain in December, and we didn't even see that. So, I mean, that's very worrisome. The actual unemployment rate, the more realistic number, the U6 number, the number that includes part-time workers, discouraged workers, that number is going up as well. It went from 17.2 to 17.3% in December. The worst sign is the participation rate. That rate dropped to 64.6%. That's the lowest since 1985. The problem with that is participation means that you've been out of work for so long that you stopped looking for work and you're no longer participating in the workforce. So they don't count you as part of the unemployed. That's another big flaw with the official unemployment number where they say it's only 10%. Well, it's 10%. You can't lose 85,000 jobs and say that, the unemployment rate is unchanged. Unless you have a phony number. And the number is very unrealistic. The number basically excludes people who stop looking for work. And we're seeing a real strong increase in people who have stopped looking for work. A lot of people are just giving up. And that's a really big story there. I want you to check out the government's website and also for determining who is employed and who is unemployed. I also want you to check out this article as well. Contracts are down. There could be a double dip in the housing market. They had sales go up when they had that special tax refund or rebate. And it looks like, according to the National Association of Realtors, when they seasonally adjust the index of sales contracts, they fell 16% from October to November. In Detroit, there's a money manager by the name of John Hines who wants to basically build large-scale farms, for-profit agricultural enterprises in Detroit. Now, that sounds awesome to me. It's a perfect city for that type of experiment because it is a big city, but they also have a lot of abandoned houses. They also have a lot of open area because they tore down a lot of those abandoned houses, and this could be a really good idea. What do you guys think about that? Obama reneges on his healthcare transparency. Well, you guys remember when Obama went on a campaign trail and he was talking about having healthcare reform discussions and meetings and negotiations on C-SPAN live on TV and all that stuff. Well, obviously he reneged on that. He's pushing for informal meetings. They're going to be informal meetings, which is another way of saying they're going to be secret meetings, as they're not going to be open to the public. So, yes, he did lie, but it's just one of the many examples of this guy lying. If you pay attention to what's going on, you'll see that this guy lies quite often. Airport security, you guys are going to love this. There's new body scanners, the strip search scanners, that allow people to actually see other people's genitals. You can see a woman's rack, so to speak. I mean, how far is this going to go? I mean, because I saw one of those images, and you can definitely see a woman's body parts, and you can even see more. And you know there's just going to be some guy at the airport who's like, check that chick out. And they're going to be like, excuse me, miss, we're going to have you go through this machine right over here. Welcome to Homeland Airlines. Leave your dignity at the door. Okay, I'm going to be on the radio. I'm going to be on the Freedomizer Network. And I'm going to do a show. I don't know if it's really going to be a show on Sunday at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. I would like you guys to come because I don't know anything about Freedomizer Radio or Blog Talk Radio. You know, so the idea, well, the problem is you have to be on air to learn how to work the controls. So if you do tune in, you're going to be listening to me and maybe Proof Negative talk about how I can work the dials and stuff like that. But I'll try to make that as interesting as humanly possible. I'll talk about some news, and hopefully I can get some of you guys to call in. So it's going to be on the Freedomizer Network. I'll put the link up in my description box. So thank you guys for watching this channel. Good day. Please rate it. Please comment. Hey, bye.